for this presentation. Now we will be looking into the concept of coplanar non-concurrent force system. In the earlier class, we have discussed coplanar concurrent force system and what are the laws and principles regarding those concepts. In this presentation, we will be looking what are non-concurrent forces and what are the principles and theorem behind this non-concurrent forces and how to solve these oriented problem. Okay. So when you talk about non-concurrent force system, that is, if a force is not acting at a point, concurrent force is a system where you have a force which is acting exactly at the point. It may be towards the point or away from the point. So in the non-concurrent system, you can see a force which is acting in a single plane, that is in a coplanar force system, and you can see point and the force is acting away from the point. So what happens? This creates a moment. So when a force which is acting apart from certain distance from the point, then a force which is created called moment force. Okay, it may be a moment which gives torsion or a moment which gives bending. So both the things can happen. So it can be a bending moment or a torsional moment. So there is a difference between that, and there is a force which is applied, and this force creates the object to rotate along its cross section. And if this is the case, then it is known as a torsion force. When a force is applied from the point, say for example, this is the point and you have a beam here and a force is applied. See, there are multiple number of force which is applied from the point A. And if you want the moment, you can take force into the distance. So the formula for moment is, the magnitude of moment is given by the product of magnitude of the force and perpendicular distance between the line of action of force. So if you need moment at a point, you need to calculate force into its perpendicular distance. Okay, so here you can see a type of moment that is called bending moment. And this is a longitudinal section. And here, this is the member which we are making a moment, and this is a torsional force and this is bending force. Also, torsional force is a continuous force where the dynamic property of a material is interested. Bending of a material along its longitudinal section is called bending moment. You can find the difference. This object has a longitudinal distance and the bending creates in the longitudinal direction. You got understanding about the moment. So here is a concept called Verrugino's theorem, and this theorem states a force which is acting under the force of moment. So this theorem is applicable for moments. So you know moment is force into perpendicular distance. And the theorem states that the sum of moments of individual forces equals to moment of their resultant force about the same point. Now say for example, if two forces are acting, this is P1 and this is P2. These are the two forces which are acting. You know that if you have two number of force, you can convert this into a single force. This is called resolution of forces, and you know the parallelogram law and polygon law. And we know that this single force resultant is cumulative of the two forces, that is P1 and P2. You can equate P1 plus P2 equal to, or this theorem, say for example, if you take a point B and if the perpendicular distance between the resultant and the point B is taken as D, so this is the moment caused due to the resultant force at point B. So if you want to take moment here, the force is R into the perpendicular distance is D. So RD will be equal to P1 into D1 plus P2 into D2. So this is the second force and this is the perpendicular distance. And for the first force, you have perpendicular distance. So this combination of moment will be equal to the moment which is created due to the resultant force. So this is the theorem which is indicated here. Okay, there is another concept called a couple. If two forces which are equal and opposite and a parallel force is known as a couple. So if you are driving a car, this is the axis of the steering. What force you will be applying in the steering is a couple force. Why? Because the force which is acting in the diagonal and whatever force which you are giving at one side will be equal to the force which is created in the opposite side, and this moment will be equal along the plane. And also in case of a tap, you will be applying a force which is equal and opposite at each side, so that the force is created in this tap. The moment will be equal to force into distance. This is the center point, and you can see a anti-clockwise movement. So the clock rotates in this direction, and the moment created due to this force F is anti-clockwise. So the same force which is in opposite direction causes the anti-clockwise movement. In the same way, you can see in the tap, so the two forces create the same amount of movement at a single direction. It may be either anti-clockwise or it may be a clockwise movement. And the properties of a couple is two equal and opposite parallel forces are required to form a couple, and two forces are required and it should be same, equal in magnitude and distance. And the magnitude of the moment of couple equals product of magnitude of one of the forces and the moment arm, that is perpendicular distance between two forces. And you can find the moment of this couple by multiplying load into the distance here. And the next thing is the resultant of the forces of a couple is always zero. So if you multiply the force into this distance and this force into distance, the resultant will be equal to zero. There are two types of couple, which is anti-clockwise and clockwise. So this couple is anti-clockwise couple. So the direction is indicated here. Why? Because it is opposite to the direction of the movement of clock. And if any movement which is in clockwise direction, you can see arrow here, if the movement is in terms of clockwise, and it is known as a clockwise movement or clockwise couple. Okay, now let us see the steps which is involved to solve the non-concurrent forces. And if you follow this 5 procedure, you might be able to solve the coplanar non-concurrent force system. The magnitude, direction, position of resultant can be determined by using this concept. And first, what you have to do is you have to calculate sum of f of x and sum of f of y, which we have earlier dealt. And next, you have to find the resultant. Let us take this as an example. Let us take a point O, and at a distance, so let us take this as an origin. So this will be 0, 0, and you have left hand side and right hand side, both negative and positive horizontal distance, and top and bottom. Let us take top as positive and bottom as negative. So from this origin, there are two forces. You can take all the horizontal force and all the vertical force, and you can resolve it. You can square these two component and root to find the resultant. You have found out the resultant here. Now, how to find the moment with respect to a point? So now this is the line of action. So you have a resultant and the line of action, it is indicated here. And what do you mean by D is the perpendicular distance between the point O and the resultant is known as the term D. So how to find D? You have to find the moment first. So how will you calculate moment? Load into perpendicular distance. So this is the formula to calculate moment. And the resultant you would have found here, you can apply this. And also, if you need x and y intercept, so what is x? In the sense, from the point O, what is the horizontal and vertical distance of the resultant force? This is known as the line of action. And if this is the line of action, this will be the horizontal intercept and vertical intercept. This is x and y. How to find that? if you have found out the summation of moment, and if you divide by sum of f of y, you will be getting x intercept. Note here that if you need x intercept, you have to divide sum of f of y. If you need y intercept, you have to substitute sum of f of x along with sum of moment. So this is the formula to find x and y intercept, also to find the distance. So let us apply these steps in order to understand the cases. The first case, a rigid plane, a rigid plate A, B, C, D. You can see the point A, B, C and D, which is given. These are the four points. Is subjected to force as shown in figure, and compute the magnitude, direction and line of action. What do you mean by magnitude? There are number of forces acting in this four point. You can see at the point A, you have a force which is acting downward of 100 kN. And at point D, you have a force 200 kN, which is along the horizontal axis of 30 degree. This force is an inclined force, and a horizontal force is acting at point C. And finally, a 200 kN force which is acting at point D, which is having an inclined angle of 45 degree. Note here that all the angle which is given from the horizontal axis. You have to compute the magnitude, direction and line of action of resultant force system with reference to point A. So the point A is our reference here. What you have to do is you have to find the resultant force. Now there are four number of forces acting. You have to convert all the forces into a single force, which is called resultant. And after finding that, you have to find the angle of the resultant, that is theta. This is known as direction. First you will find the resultant magnitude and the direction, and after that line of action of resultant. In the sense, you have to find x intercept from the point A and y direction from the point A, also the perpendicular distance of the resultant force. Okay, so let us find this. So what is the first step? You have to find sum of all horizontal force and sum of all vertical force. So that is sum of f of x. So in this four points, what are the horizontal force which are acting? 100 kN, which is acting at right hand side. So if a force is acting right hand side, we can take it as plus 100. And you have an inclined force here, can be resolved horizontally as well as vertically. So when you resolve horizontally, 200 into cos 30. So plus 200 into cos 30, it is acting at right hand side, and 200 into cos 45, which is acting left hand side, that is minus. So 200 into cos 45 degree. If you add that, you will be getting 131.78 kN. So now let us take all the vertical forces. So 100 kN is acting at downward, which is negative. So minus 100, and 200 kN, which is acting at upward. So 200 into sine 30 plus, so plus 200 into sine 30, and this is a downward force. After resolving, you will get a downward force. So 200 into sine 45, which is minus. So 200 into sine 45, which is minus. So after adding this, you will be getting minus 141.42 kN. After getting sum of f of x and f of y, you can find the resultant. And the resultant, it is found as 193.30. Next thing is, you need magnitude is found out. Magnitude of resultant is found out, and the direction, that is theta. How to find theta? Sum of f of y divided by sum of f of x. This is the formula, and f of y is 141.42 and f of x is 131.78. So if you divide this and if you tan inverse, you will be getting minus 1.073. is the answer you are getting. And after that, if you tan inverse, you will be getting minus 42.02 degree, which is the angle. Next, let us find the line of action. What do you mean by line of action? Is you have to find the x intercept and y intercept of the resultant. So the resultant force is found out, and it is at the negative direction. And let us find the x, y and d term. So we have a formula, that is sum of moment divided by sum of Fy to find x. So you need some summation of moment. So you need the moment at the point of A. So let us find the moment here. So if you are taking the moment at point A, if there is any force is acting at this point, you have to omit that. Why? Because if you want to take moment, the formula is load into distance. So even though if you are having a load which is 100 kN at point A, there is no distance. So distance is zero. However, the moment will be zero. What are the other points? D, C and B. So you have to take moment at these three forces. So 200 kN, which can be resolved horizontally as well as vertically. So if you resolve horizontally, 200 cos 30 will be your answer. And there will be no perpendicular distance. So if you resolve vertically, 200 sin 30, the force will become vertical. So with the action of force, you have the perpendicular distance. So you can take 200 into sin 30. So 200 into sin 30 is given here. So which is anti-clockwise. Why it is written here as negative, which is anti-clockwise. So if the load is, if the moment is acting in this manner, and you will be getting anti-clockwise. Why? The moment of action is anti-clockwise. And next force is called 100 into the distance is 1 meter. How? From the point A, you have a force which is 100 and at a distance of 1 meter. So this is the perpendicular distance. Note here that for each and every force, the perpendicular distance is very much important to find the moment at the point. So 100 into 1. So this will be acting at a clockwise with respect to point A. So this force will rotate in this direction. So this is a clockwise moment. So 100 into 1. So here you have plus 100 into 1. Okay. Now you have the next force, that the 200, it can be resolved into horizontal and vertical direction. So if it is resolved in horizontal, 200 into cos 45, you will be having one force. And for this force, you have a perpendicular distance. So 200 cos 45 into the distance is 1 meter. And 200 cos 45 into distance is 1 meter. Why it is written negative here? It is acting left hand side. So with respect to point A, this will rotate in anti-clockwise manner. Hence it is written as negative. And when you resolve this inclined force in downward direction, note here that this force will become along the axis, that is axis of A. So 200 sin 45 into distance will be 0 here. There will be no perpendicular distance. Hence, so 200 into sin 45 into 0. So for the two inclined force, you have zero moment, that is 200 cos 30 into 0 and 200 into cos 45 into 0. So these are the zero distance here. And if you add all the components, you will be getting minus 141.42 kN. So whenever you are taking a moment, note here that load should be perpendicular in order to take a moment. Now we have found that the sum of moment is minus 141.42 and the formula is summation of MA divided by R. So now you know the R is 193.3. R we have found out that 193.3. And if you substitute, you will be getting D as 0.732 meter. And if you need x-intercept, you have to divide the component. You have 141.42 as MA and the sum of Fy is also 141.42. So if you divide this, you will be getting 1 meter. And for y-intercept, you have to substitute summation of MA divided by summation of Fx. So summation of F of x is 131.78 here. So if you divide that, you will be getting 1.073 meter. Now you have found that from the point A, the y-intercept is 1.073 meter. So this is 1 meter, which is given here up to B. So after that you have 0.073 meter, and you know that from the point A, x intercept of 1 meter, you got the next distance for the resultant. Note here that this is the resultant line and the d distance. So the d is the distance between point A and this resultant. So the perpendicular distance is known as d, and d here is 0.732 meter. So these are the three intercepts, and you found out the resultant and the angle of resultant. Now let us take another example and let us understand the three concepts, that is magnitude, direction and position of resultant force. Now you can see that a force is acting. Let us take a point A. You can see that the forces are not acting at a single point, at each and every side of this member. So you can see a member here which is in this shape, and number of forces are acting at a scattered manner. So all the forces are not converged into a single point. At each and every point you have different force. Now this problem comes under non-concurrent force system. So if there is any non-concurrent force system, for finding the resultant force you have to use Verignon's theorem. So under this you can find the resultant, the direction and the position. Okay, in this case you have to find the resultant with respect to the point A. So this is point A. So how many forces are there? 100 force which is acting at downward, and at point B you have 200 newton which is acting at an angle of 60 degree, and you have a UDL. The UDL is known as uniformly distributed load. So some force is distributed evenly to 1 meter. So this load which is acting vertically downward direction, and you have a force of 500 newton. So these are the different number of force. You have 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have 4 number of force, and the distance are given with respect to A. So let us convert this UDL. What do you mean by UDL is uniformly distributed load. So 100 newton per meter. So how many meters are here? You have 1 meter. So if you multiply 100 newton into 1, that is 100 newton per meter into 1, you will be getting 100 newton. So you have converted this UDL into a single force. This single force will be acting at the center of the distance. So if you have 1 meter, this UDL will be acting at center, that is 0.5 meter from the point C. So the center of this 1 meter will be 0.5. Okay, so let us find sum of f of x and sum of f of y. So what are the horizontal forces which are here? This is a vertical force you cannot consider, and this is an inclined force. For this inclined force you can convert into horizontal as well as vertical. Okay, if I want to resolve it horizontally, 200 into cos 60, so which will be at left hand side. After resolving it will be acting at left hand side. So 200 cos 60, it is written here, which is minus. And also you have a UDL. This UDL will be acting purely vertical distance, so there is no horizontal component, and you have horizontal load of 500 newton which is acting right hand side, so which is plus. So plus 500, if you add that you will be getting 400 newton as sum of f of x. And if you want to find sum of f of y, all vertical force, so you have a downward force of 100, that is minus 100, and if you resolve this inclined component, 200 sine 60. So when resolving vertically you have to use sine theta, and this is acting downward, so minus 200 sine 60. So minus 200 sine 60 is given here, and the UDL which is acting downward, which is purely acting at vertical direction, so that is minus 100. So another minus 100 is written here. If you add this you will be getting minus 373.21 newton. And if you want to find resultant, you can square this and root, you will be getting 547.07 newton. And if you need tan theta, sum of f of y divided by sum of f of x. So if you divide this you will be getting a value, if you tan inverse, you will be getting this theta, that is minus 43.02 degree. Okay. So now in this axis, this is the negative direction and your resultant is acting at a negative direction of 43.02 degree. Now we have plotted the resultant and we should know at which point. So the resultant is acting at negative direction and you should plot the angle. So this angle is known as the resultant angle. This angle is 43.02 degree. And what is the distance from point A to this resultant? And what is the horizontal distance? What is the vertical distance? That is x and y intercept. Also, the perpendicular distance from the resultant. So, all you have to find with respect to A. So, you have a formula for that. For that, you have to find summation of moment at the point A. So, let us take the moment at point A. What are the force here? 100 Newton. Do you have any perpendicular distance? So, for the vertical force, horizontal will be perpendicular distance. It is acting along the point A, so 100 into 0. So you should not take this force. And you have a inclined force here. This is the second force. So if you resolve horizontally, 200 into cos 60, this horizontal force is along with this point A. So you don't have any vertical distance. That is why 200 cos 60 is not taken. And if you resolve vertically, 200 sin 60. So 200 sin 60 can be taken. So what is the distance from point A? So this load is acting at 1 meter distance. So that is why 1 meter is acting here. Why it is taken as plus? Why? Because this load is acting clockwise. So if you take moment at point A, this will be rotating in clockwise direction. And okay. What about the UDL here? I have said that this UDL can be converted into a point force which is acting at 0.5 meter distance. So from the C, this UDL will be acting at center, which is at 0.5 meter. And what is the total distance from point A? This is 0.5 and this is 1 and this is 1. So totally 2.5 meter. So 100 Newton force which is acting at 2.5 meter distance. So 100 into 2.5 meter. Which is also a clockwise. So this force is acting at clockwise, hence it is plus. And at last you have 500 Newton from the point A. This load has a perpendicular distance of 0.5. The force is acting at horizontal axis. So you have to take the distance as vertical axis, that is perpendicular. You cannot take the 3 meter. So find the difference here. If a force is acting horizontally, you have to take vertical distance. So 500 into 0.5. That is the line of action of point A. So 500 into 0.5. This is acting anti-clockwise direction. Hence, it is negative. And if you add that, you will be getting moment as 173.21 Newton meter. What is the unit of moment is? Newton meter. Why? Because the load is in terms of Newton and the distance in terms of meter. So the unit will be in terms of Newton meter. So whenever you find the answer for moment, you should remember to apply the unit as Newton meter. If it is given in terms of kilonewton, your answer will be in terms of kilonewton meter. Okay. Now how to find the summation of MA? You know summation of MA is 173.21 divided by the R. You know R as 547.07. We have found earlier. If you divide this, you will be getting 0.317 meter. And x-intercept and y-intercept you can find by substituting this formula. And you will be getting this answer. So finally, we have got y-intercept from the point A as 0.433 meter. And x-intercept, which is the distance from point A to the resultant, which is 0.464, which is the x-intercept, and the perpendicular distance D from the resultant force to the point A is 0.317 meter. And this is the process to find the resultant force. You have converted all the forces into a resultant and you have found the resultant force with respect to a point which is given there. So by using the Verignon's theorem, you could be able to find out the resultant force of an object. If multiple number of forces given, you can convert into a single force and you can find the moment. So note here that if a force which is acting in an object which is not acting exactly at the point, you have a new force which is called a moment. So this force can be either clockwise moment or anti-clockwise moment. If the moment is rotating in the same way as your clock rotates, it is called clockwise movement, and if it is in the opposite direction, it is taken as anti-clockwise movement. So clockwise movement is taken as positive and anti-clockwise movement is taken as negative. So I hope that this class would have given you some knowledge about the coplanar non-concurrent force system. See you soon. Happy learning. See you again. Thank you.